If you think about the adoption of electric vehicles, what everybody's worried about today is, where are you going to charge? When are you going to charge? The most common question I get is, how long does it take to charge? The big picture vision is electrified roadways, so you no longer need to think about, do I charge at work? Do I charge at home? How long is it going to take? Is my car going to be fully charged to be able to get to work, pick up the kids, get to the grocery store? So the beauty of electrified roadways is you charge as you drive.
In ENRX, we believe that electrification is key to the future. We also share the vision of carbon-free driving. In the Aspire project, these two things come nicely together. We are extremely proud of being selected as the provider of the technology enabling electric roads in the Aspire project, where the Aspire Research Institute and the Central Expressway in Florida try out this technology and will use it in a commercial road.
The project itself is part of a new build that CFX is doing, a 5-mile stretch of roadway in Orlando, just west of Disney World. And we're gonna take 3/4 of a mile and make it an electrified roadway section. We are doing this in concrete because 60% of the nation's interstate highways are in concrete, 40% are in asphalt. And one of the things that we're doing here at Utah State University, a 40-meter section in the test track here to learn from that, to understand how do we make things far more efficient when we get to Florida, when we're gonna be doing 30 times that length.
Aspire had its foundations as a research center. And in fact, we're a National Science Foundation engineering research center. We'll maintain that core, and we're proud of the technology base that we've built from. As a team within the Aspire Center, internal and external, we have a grand vision. This is really what binds us together. This cannot be done by any individual, by any single institution, by any company, by any industry. We're literally looking at cross-industry transformations that impact communities, impact states, impact the entire nation, and can't roll out without worldwide collaboration and coordination. This is in partnership with the Central Florida Expressway, together with ENRX and Oldcastle and CRH and Aspire, and the utilities are going to be involved in that space, the contractors. This is a big deal. This is a significant demonstration on that stepping stone towards what we'd like to see as a future moonshot.
As you have a fleet of trucks, now I know you're not in the fleet business, but you're using vehicles. How do you become a user of these technologies also and be environment friendly? How does this help your value proposition, not only impacting society and the environment, but maybe also as a economic proposition? Imagine your trucks, where you're able to recharge them wirelessly. They're in constant use. You're getting more out of your asset. You don't need to stop, fuel them up. And the maintenance usually on electric vehicles is lower than diesel or gas. So there's all sorts of value propositions, things that hit you that you could be both a user and a contributor of.
So this is a high-powered technology. So the system that's going in is a 200 kilowatt, which will be enough to actually power a fully loaded semi-truck doing 70 miles an hour on the freeway. The technology itself is a wireless induction technology. So just as I can take my cell phone and I can put it on a wireless charger and I can charge it, we can do the same thing by putting a charging receiving coil on the bottom of the truck, and we're embedding the induction power technology into the pavement itself. So as the truck drives over the roadway, it charges as it's going.
We look at things like, is it safe to be sitting, say, inside of a bus or a vehicle while it's charging, or standing next to a bus while you're waiting to get on and off? And we've done extensive measurements, worked through the standardization committee. We've got a sub-team that's focused on what they call EMC and EMF, which is electromagnetic compatibility and fields or radiation. And we do thorough testing by third parties, make sure it's certified versus the accepted standards in the world. The way it works from a technical standpoint is you've got multiple levels of detection, whether the pads are actually aligned. So you've got a high level that just says, hey, I'm a bus, I'm coming up to the charger, I want you to wake up, you know, here's my name and number. And then as you get the bus close to the pad, you've got a system that detects that it's done some gross alignment, as we call it. And then as it gets even closer, we're able to say that it's aligned or centered over the path. So we know that that's actually ready to turn on. So unless the vehicle is directly over the pad or the electrified roadway, it's not going to have energy delivered to it, so it's safe to be around. The other beauty of it is once you get energy and it says I'm over the pad, as soon as you move off of that pad, we can detect that it's no longer aligned and it automatically and safely shuts down. So a nice safe technology out there in the world.
We are putting in the field a system that the big term that we are using is interoperability in many levels. The most important interoperability here is that with one only infrastructure, you're going to be able to charge any sort of vehicle. And this is challenging because you have trucks that need much more energy. These trucks will be fed with 200 kilowatts, which is a huge power. Other vehicles that are smaller transporters will be having 100 kilowatts. And even our vehicles, passenger vehicles, will find their own filling level with 50 kilowatts. So that means this is the first time that we have been able to do a one-only infrastructure fitting all the vehicles that you have in the field.
One of the key things for this technology is to really decrease the cost of how do we build in long-haul freight movement across the U.S. for zero carbon.
One drop-in approach that we're considering and have already demonstrated is having precast modules. And so the entire lane sections precast. So we can have a precast yard nearby with a certain level of trained personnel that can implement the technology in a precast yard. And then we can simply bring those precast segments with, you know, nearly automated connectors that drop in, much like the dowel interaction placement of existing concrete precast roadways.
If we can charge the vehicles while they're moving on the roadway, now we can decrease that size of the battery, because we can shrink that 500 mile battery to a 50 mile battery, enough for you to go off the roadway, drop your trailer, pick up your next trailer, get back on. There's enough energy to keep you moving and slowly recharge your battery over time. And that means instead of $150,000 battery, we can shrink that to $15,000. We can take a 20,000 pound battery and we can shrink it to 2,000 pounds.
We are really gathering all the elements to make really the next step on the technology. So we are doing interoperability, we are doing really the field deployment on a real highway. And for this, with the new standards, we are really bringing the whole technology in a very big step forward. And we are building something for our society that will last and is really, really answering everyone's needs. It's not just a sector, not just the trucks, not just the passengers, is really an infrastructure for everyone.
Wireless charging itself is a technology that's been around for quite a while. So ENRX, the company that is putting the technology into the roadway at CFX, has been in the industrial space for a long time. So actually in Orlando, they have a theme park ride that's underneath the water. And ENRX actually powers that from technology they put in, I don't know, 14 plus years ago, so that as the cars are passing over that, it's wirelessly coupling energy into the cars in the underwater ride. So the technology has been around for a long time. It's just how do we use it in different applications? The project at Central Florida Expressway, or CFX, is designed to show that technology is possible.